Okay, let's do some math for fun. And today, I have this beautiful exponential equation problem from the Stanford Math Tournament in 2023, the algebra part of it. Here is the question. The capital N is the sum of all the real solutions to this equation. And notice that there's a parameter k. And right here, k goes from 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 2023. At the end, we want to compute 2 to the nth power. So in fact, we don't just have one exponential equation, we have a lot of them. Because for each k, what's happening is that, imagine k is equal to 2, then you will have to look at 2 to the 2x minus 2 to the x plus 1 plus 1 minus 1 over 2 to the second equals 0. Aha! Look at this, find out what x is, and then in fact you have two solutions for it, and then add them up, and then congrats, you're done. And then move to the next one, and then do it again, and so on. But of course, you know it. This is not the way to go. But anyway, though, you should pause the video right now, think about it first, and then see the solution. All right, now let's see how we can solve this right here. First, we have 2 to the 2x. We can look at that as 2 to the x, and then square by the rule of exponent. Likewise here, x plus 1 in the power, we can look at that as minus. Let's write down 2 to the first right here first, and then times 2 to the x. This is now the same. And now I will just keep this as how it is. Plus 1 minus 1 over k squared equals 0. Have a look. This right here is actually a quadratic equation by in terms of 2 to the x power. So right here, you can go ahead and do a substitution to make it look easier like a quadratic, or you can just do it. So it's kind of up to you. I will just do it. To solve this quadratic equation though, in fact, of course, we can use the quadratic formula, but this is actually factorable. Yeah, I saw the solution, that's how I know it's factorable. At first, I used the quadratic formula. It's not so bad, but factoring is of course cleaner. So I'll show you guys how to factor it. This right here is 1 minus 1k over k squared. We can look at this as 1 minus k times 1 plus k, because that's really just the difference of two squares. All right? And then I'm just going to factor it like the following. I need to get this square, so I, of course I need 2 to the x times 2 to the x. Done. And of course, it looks like we need to have this and that factor, right? So of course, I need to have the 1 minus 1 over k, and then 1 plus 1 over k. Good. And then we have to be careful though. We have to make sure that this plus that equals negative 2. Well, in fact, we need to have subtraction here, minus minus. So it's a negative, this blue part times the negative blue part gives us this part. Together, we add up to negative 2, right? Because this and that cancel out. So it's just like that. Now, we know this factor will equal to 0, so that means 2 to the x must equal to, bring this to the other side of the 0, so we get 1 minus 1 over k. And similarly, 2 to the x has to be equal to 1 plus 1 over k. So on the left-hand side, take log base 2 on both sides, x equals log base 2 of 1 minus 1 over k, and then take log base 2, x equals log base 2 of 1 plus 1 over k. So these are the two solutions for this equation. And remember, we have this many k values, right? And then n is the sum of all the roots. So right here, let's just go ahead and add them up. And this is such a well-designed equation because now, as we can see, we can use the property of logarithms. Of course, combine them, we just get one single log and base 2, and we just have to multiply the sides together. So this times that, well, we did that right here already. So that's just 1 minus 1 over k squared. Well, now, what is n? And it's the sum of all this ranging from 2 to 2023. And you might have wondered, how come we didn't let k equals 1? You're about to see that. So n equals the sum, here's the summation part. When k goes from 1, I mean 2 to 20, 23. And then we just have to write that down right here. So we have log base 2 of 1 minus 1 over k squared. Yeah. If we can figure this out, and then at the end we just do 2 to the power, we'll be done, yeah? So how do we do it? This right here turns out to be like a telescoping series in the multiplication sense. Here's the deal. Firstly, if you put 1 in here, you get log base 2 of 0 as undefined. That's why we cannot let n equals, we cannot let k equals 1. But that doesn't matter. Here, this is telescoping in the following sense. Let's go ahead and just get the common denominator right here. I am going to write that down real quick for you guys. This is the same as k squared over k, and then this is the minus 1, yeah? So I'm actually going to just factor the top, and then we will get k minus 1 times k plus 1 over k squared. And to see why this is telescoping, the best way is, let's just go ahead and write down a few terms and then see what's going on. So when k is equal to 2, we will have log base 2 of, just plugging 2 in here, do not multiply the out. So 2 squared, and then 2 in here is 1, times 2 in here is 3. So that is what we have. This is when k is equal to 2. Now we will have to add. The next one is when k is equal to 3. So put it here, we have log base 2 of, here will be 3 squared. 3 in here becomes 2, 3 in here becomes 4. And then let's just write down a few more. So plus, let's do one more. Log base 2 of, when k is 4, we get 4 squared, and then 3 times 5, and so on, so on, so on. And then, of course, that's also write down the last term. Log base 2 of, the last term is, of course, the year of 2023. And then, put it here, we have 2022 times 2024, which is this year now. So we have all that stuff. Now, by the log property, we just have to multiply the sides. So this right here becomes one single log, and then we have this part, which is 1 times 3 over 2 squared first. Next, we multiply with that, which is 2 times 4 over 3 squared. Next, we multiply with that, which is 3 times 5 over 4 squared, and then so on, so on, so on. At the end, we have 2022 times 2024 over 2023 squared, like this. Okay, here it comes to the most important part. How can we cancel this stuff out? Have a look. Here we have 1, 3, cancels with one of them, but here we have another one, so it cancels out completely. Now for this right here, 2, and that cancel, but we are not going to get another 2, right? So this 2 right here stays. And then this 4 cancel with one of them, but you know the next one will be a 4 that will cancel out with that. And then the 5 will also be canceled out. And then blah, 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 blah. And then right here, here's the deal. 2023, are we going to cancel stuff out? Yes, the term before that can cancel out one of them. And this will cancel with one of the things from before. So in the end, we will just get log base 2 of, on the top we just have 2024 times 1, which is 2024, over 2 times 2023. Reduce that. So here we have log base 2 of, just reduce that the regular sense, so 1012. So we have 1012 over 2023. And ladies and gentlemen, this is n. At the end, you are going to do 2 to the nth power. But luckily, this is base 2. So 2 to the base 2 stuff is just inside. So the answer is 10, 12 over 20, 23. And I fit everything on this board. Oh my goodness. It's an amazing feeling. That's it.